There has been a widely spread groundless message among tacticians in the tavern. It says that only the wisest Maiars can help the tacticians glimpse the fate of Middle-earth.
Ah, Radagast. I see you've arrived precisely when you meant to.
I'm as surprised as you are.
You haven't forgotten, have you?
Is it today?
It is. Perhaps Saruman is right in saying you've indulged a bit too much in the Hobbit's pipeweed.
Saruman doesn't know what's good for him.
Indeed, his taste is lacking. Well, you must remember, today we come as the lead wizards of Lord of the Rings Rise to War to introduce Season 3 content.
That's right. Then let us proceed.
Without further ado, let's begin.
Well, you see, the theme of Season 3, Rebuilding Glory, is closely based on the game's new background story. After a long-running war, Middle-earth was left devastated. Each faction has been heavily affected by this event, but every race, determination, helped them to survive.
In other words, due to the chaos of this conflict, each faction's spawn points will be somewhat reduced.
Yes, but that's not all. Few resources will become more scarce. Farming will become much more difficult. The best way to develop for players will be to expand much more than before.
The factions of Middle-earth, if they mean to survive, must rebuild. Structure development is a new system that we've added in Season 3, which will give players the option to build and expand upon significant structures they've already occupied. It will offer various buffs and resource accumulations that may help you along your journey in this season.
Players are closely bound to each other, and each individual's fate will be tied to that of their faction. In Season 3, the structure development rankings will show how well each faction is capturing and developing their structure. Players can complete tasks to earn contribution points. The Fellowship and Warben store will be updated with new items. In light of these changes, how you go about developing your structures will be key to rebuilding your faction's glory. Well, you see, after a faction captures a structure, it can upgrade the structure's development level by dispatching commanders to garrison in it. By completing various tasks issued by the structure, it can unlock very special rewards, even buffs for your faction and special abilities.
At the same time, the structures, once occupied, will provide a movement range not dissimilar to the forts that you have in our game. Henceforth, the strategic value of such a structure will lie not only in expanding one's territory, but also in introducing new functions to your faction and to your fellowships and warbands.
Speaking of which, defensive camp runes have been added to the game. Those will give players the opportunity to capture them, which will create mercenaries that will defend or clear specific areas of the map in the name of your faction.
This idea came from a player suggestion. We found it quite intriguing.
Indeed. I can't wait to see how we will bring change to the game.
Why, of course, they're the neutral camp barracks.
Yes, indeed. That is a very big change. You see, we realized that so many players love using neutral units. Ants, Mumakils, Eagles. Well, having any of them would be a blessing.
Why, of course, because they're so powerful.
Yes, indeed. And in Season 3, we will have so many more brand new neutral units. Like...
Okay, that's quite enough. We can leave the surprises to the players to experience in Season 3.
Absolutely. Many players love to use neutral unit, partly because of the wide variety of options out there. But you see, too few players got to experience them. So in Season 3, we decided to provide a new way for players to recruit those neutral units. The number of neutral camps on the map has been reduced, but a neutral camp field barracks will be available for players to build, provided their structure has reached the appropriate development level. After this, all players in the same faction will be able to recruit the corresponding neutral unit if this camp has been constructed.
In previous seasons, most factions chose their development routes based upon which enemies they wanted to face and in what way. With the introduction of the structure development system in Season 3, factions will be able to shift their focus and consider new elements such as the buffs and bonuses provided by structures located in certain regions and choose their strategy accordingly.
Take for example Hobbiton. Developing this structure would raise your storage cap. And then, if the defensive camp ability of Hobbiton has been researched, players can now build neutral camp unique to Hobbiton.
At this point in time, we should say a word about Dol Guldur, the season goal of Season 3. For the faction that occupies Dol Guldur, the players in that faction's rings will undergo a terrifying and powerful change. Various ring techs, including your territory cap, will double, depending, of course, on the development level of Dol Guldur.
Our hope is that players will plan their structure development depending on regional rivalries. Every expansion route is unique and provides a different experience. Based on the choices you make, you will be able to reach various different endings and write your own legend.
And how exactly do you plan to write your own legend?
Well, fight for the evil faction, of course.
We already have one wizard engaged in such tomfoolery. One is enough.
Of course, many, many questions have been asked on social media, and we selected a few of them here to answer on the show. It seems to me that this is the first time that you're doing this, right? Am I detecting a hint of nervousness?
My first time indeed, but a wizard does not fear such trifles. A wizard fears only his server ID being discovered.
I see. Is it perhaps because you're afraid of logging in and seeing your settlement uprooted?
Either this or receiving large amounts of hate mail, but yes.
Ah, of course. My friend, if you would, please do the honor.
Well, without further ado. This question comes from Nembedil El Sabio. Is it never night in Middle-earth? It could be awesome if units and commanders can get some benefits during daytime and others during nighttime. Day and night play an important role in Middle-earth, and maybe you can do something about it. Thanks for reading all this stuff. I love the game. Glad to hear he loves the game. Well, for day and night cycles, it can be very difficult to implement because we are a worldwide server game. So if we have some players in, say, Asia and some players in South America, it's very difficult to decide who will be experiencing night and day and when. Should we go on a 24-hour cycle, a 12-hour cycle, 6 hours? There's many factors to consider, but the core design philosophy is indeed a good one, and we are considering it.
Now it's my turn. What will we find? Oh, this comes from a player named Issel. Will there be different colors of tiles for the different factions? Well, you see, Issel, this is a really good suggestion, but we have a small problem here. We have so many factions now, 10, 12, who knows how many in the future. If every faction would have a specific color
upon their tiles. It would cause a lot of issues. So many colors. The readability would be a little bit confusing. That's why we think that it is actually not feasible for the moment.
Oh, and on to the next. This comes from the player Etherstride. Will there be a refresh of events like the Red Book of Westmarch in Season 3, or will we rely on new events coming up?
Very good question. Well, you see, I heard that that game developer, Nicholas, I remember, he told us about this actually in previous videos. You see, there will be a new feature coming later, but not necessarily for Season 3. But it would be available for more players, actually. It sounds a little bit like the Red Books of Westmarch from what I heard, but it will provide a different type of gameplay, and players will be able to enjoy it every week, I heard. Let's pick the last one now. There we go. It comes from player named Tib1503. Will you have surprise events like the boss on this one? Surprise event like the boss. What I feel that Tim is telling us is, will we have more bosses in this season? Is that right, my dear Gandalf?
Well, if the question is, will we have more bosses? The answer is yes. Over time, we will add more bosses. Not necessarily bound to a season, but in terms of overall content, there will be more bosses, yes.
Thank you. Thank you all for meeting with us today. I hope that you are very pleased with what you heard.
Yes, and if you want to convene with other tacticians and discuss matters related to the game, there's apparently some sort of council or something called Discord. If that's a thing, you can go there.
And it seems, as it stands, that Magic Gandalf, our purpose here has not yet been fulfilled.
Indeed. So, we'll be seeing more of us.
Until next time.